Not much police activity. One more channel. They must be all at the donut shop. Okay. Well, that's good for us. Well, check that again in a little bit. Well, thank you very much for showing up. Appreciate it. My name is Paul. It's a pleasure to meet you. People call me ER, Uncle E. You can call me Paul. Honestly, it's fine. That's my real first name. I am a dad, and some people consider me an uncle, you know, but I just try to be myself, you know. Big night tonight. I'm really excited myself. Probably you are as well. A little anxious, have to admit, with, what we're about to do. But, I think everything's gonna, I have a really good feeling about this tonight. I think everything's gonna go according to plan. Okay? So, before we get any further, and, thanks for meeting me out here in the garage, by the way. But normally I go into the basement and put the black background up, but I don't want the family, my wife and son, to hear what we're planning. So, here in the garage, you might hear some traffic in the background. There's a highway. It's not too far away. Before we go any further, would you care for some tea? I have some nice hot water, or water, as we like to say, here in the mid-Atlantic region of the North American continent. I have some hot tea, hot water ready, a fresh, clean cup, and some black tea, which I thought maybe might help calm you down for what we're about to embark on. Yeah? Okay, great. I have some Lipton black tea. I'm not much of a tea drinker. I like coffee, although I don't drink coffee religiously. But I'll have coffee more often than I have tea. What about you? Are you a tea person? Coffee person? Maybe you don't like either one? Maybe you like milk. I do have some milk in the fridge, but it's kind of take time away and all that, so some tea? Okay. Open that up. Here's all the tea bags. Take one of those. Maybe I don't even have to make the tea, and I'll just do this for the next hour. 3 hours of teabag sounds. Play around with your tea bag too much. By the way, can you hear the katydid? I hope you don't mind that sound. I kind of like coming out here once in a while just to hear the distant traffic. Hear the katydids. You know, kind of soothing in and of itself. Anyway, there's your tea bag. And now for the hot water. It's not scalding hot, but there we go. Okay. I apologize. I don't have any sugar or creamer, okay? So, just black. They say you like your coffee black when you don't have any cream or sugar in it. I guess we could say you like your black tea black as well. Black tea. Here you go. I'll set it right here over on the table. So that you, my friend, can partake of it whenever you please. Partake. Parched. Okay. All right, so I have quite a few things to go over before we get started on our grand adventure. Quite a lot of things. Where should I start first? Oh, I do have a brief questionnaire that I need to ask of you. I hope you don't mind, okay? It's nothing too personal or invasive. All right, just a moment. I I'll be using this Bic. Made in France, by the way. How about that? I don't know why they're made in France. Wouldn't it be cheaper to make it in China? Anyway, the classic multicolored pen, four-colored pen. Green, which is currently selected. You can see green is currently depressed down. Blue, red, and black. So, my friend, and we can just there's the four ink cartridges. So, my friend, my accomplice, although I don't like that word, accomplice, a better partner, protege, perhaps. Yeah. Anyway, my friend, which color should we use for the questionnaire? Black, green, blue, or red? Which one do you think will be the lucky color tonight? What's that? Blue? Yeah, I like blue. Blue has a very calming effect, like the sky, like the color of the case. Yes, we'll go with blue. There we go. Okay. Thank you, my friend, for helping me with such an important decision. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. We have six questions I'll be asking you just to make sure you're a good fit for what we're about to embark on this quest, this escapade. Okay. Question number one. Take your time answering. There's no rush. Okay. Well, we do have to kind of get going in about an hour. There is somewhat of a time frame, a window. Question number one. Have you ever robbed a bank before? No? That's okay. Me neither. But I watched plenty of movies and a couple documentaries, so easy peasy. And that's fine. You have zero bank robbing experience, correct? Okay. And that's fine because we're always hiring, zero experience required, and I am an equal opportunity employer, okay? All right, so zero experience. Okay, no worries. Question number two. How fast can you run? Just in case that we happen to get caught, which the chances are slim, so don't worry about it. But in the rare off chance that that someone catches us and that someone is a member of local or federal law enforcement agency and they happen to catch us robbing the bank and we're unable to get to our getaway car, or if we're being chased in our getaway vehicle and we have to jump out and run away, and just at any point that we have to run away, can you run fast? Are you going to be a detriment? Are you going to be a liability? Or can you run pretty fast if your life depends on it? You can run fairly fast? Okay. I'll be honest, I'm 52. I really can't run fast anymore. I could probably run pretty fast for about, you know, 10 seconds, maybe 20 tops, before I'm just completely out of breath. I'm not as young as I used to be. But, so I might actually be more of a liability and get caught if we happen to, you know, have to run away. But you can run fairly fast. Okay, that's good. So, can run fairly fast if need be. Okay. Question number 3. We're halfway done. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Are you in good health? For the most part. Again, this is going to be a very stressful job situation. So, and we're going to be under a lot of stress and pressure to get this job done. All right? So, and in case you have to run away, right? So, are you in decent health so that you're not gonna just topple over due to high blood pressure or anything like that, have a heart attack while we're in the middle of breaking into the safe, for example? You're in pretty good health. Okay, that's great. I am too, for the most part. I don't have, you know, high blood pressure issues, or, you know, I don't have to avoid operating heavy machinery or anything like that. So you are in good health. Excellent. You're not the first quote-unquote applicant. I've been seeing quite a few folks over the last few nights. And then, you know, not my cup of tea, so to speak. But you, as soon as you showed up here, I just had a feeling you were going to be the one to really help this endeavor to be a success, okay, this mission. So, yeah, I'm glad, I'm really thankful that you showed up here. Yeah, I don't think I can do this without you. I mean that. Okay, so you're in good health, can run pretty fast. Next question, question 4. Are you a cop? You're not. Okay, you answered that so very quickly and with such confidence that, it makes me kind of wonder if you were waiting for me to ask you that and you actually are a cop. But I'll take your word for it. Okay, So not a cop. Excellent. Next question, question number 5. Do you have a living will or any last words? You know, last will and testament, so to speak, just in case something goes south during our little excursion and you were to pass away from this existence. Do you want your belongings, any of your worldly possessions, to go to anyone? Okay, all right. So let me just write that down, okay? Right. Any last words? Okay. All right. Okay, yeah, I like that. All right, what I'll do is I'm gonna leave this here with a note to my wife. Yeah, in the event that you and I happen to perish perilously on this little mission of ours, I'll have a note here, you know, telling my wife your last, you know, will and testament, your final words, and then I'm gonna have some too. So, okay. All right. Final question, more of an essay. In your own words, explain why you want to rob a bank. Okay. Mm-hmm. Right. Okay, yep. All right. Okay. Anything else you'd like to add? All right. Okay. Is that it? Okay, my friend, well, I mean, even though you have zero bank robbing experience, just like me, you can run fairly fast if you need to. You have decent health. You're not a cop. Big plus. I got your last will and testament, and a great explanation. A really, you know, great essay, short essay, as to why you want to rob a bank, okay? Well, you pass the questionnaire. A lot of previous applicants failed miserably, so you should be proud of yourself. All right, let me put this away. I just want to perform a couple quick little medical checkups. I'm not a doctor, but this will help just to ensure you're of good medical health, okay? So I just need you to look straight ahead at the letters. Tell me, how do they do it at the eye doctor? Cover one eye. So cover one eye and read the smallest line that you can, okay? Let's put it right there. Okay, that's pretty good. Now, cover the other eye and do the same thing. Okay, great. You have pretty decent eyesight, vision, yeah. last thing I want to do is use this stethoscope. I bought this for to use in different roleplay videos. I want to listen to your heart, make sure, and your lungs, and again, just to make sure you are in good physical health. Okay. All right. Testing. All right. So let me just listen to your heart. Yeah. Your heart, it's not beating very fast. Just like boom, boom. Into your lungs. So all I need for you to do is just to breathe in deeply and then exhale. Do that 3 times for each lung. Start with your left lung. Go ahead and breathe in and exhale. Again, breathe in and exhale. Now that sounds pretty neat. Usually in the videos that I do, I mean, I'm doing a role play and there's no one, you know, I'm doing it to a camera, so I never actually hear anyone breathing, but with you being here, I actually get to hear the heartbeat. I actually get to use this for the first time, okay? The other lung, just 2 times each. Breathe in. Exhale. Again, breathe in. Exhale. That's so neat. Wow. You know, I wish sometimes I was a doctor, you know, hear all the cool things and see all the cool things. Except when it comes to like prostate exam or some really gross things. I don't want to do the gross things. I'm going to do the cool stuff, you know? Okay. Oh, I'm also going to use this to break into this safe. That was another question I forgot to. Have you ever cracked a safe before? I haven't. It's pretty easy though. You just got to turn the dial one way until you hear click. You turn it the other way, click, turn it the other way while you use this, click, and then it opens. Simple. Like I said, I've seen plenty of movies, so. All right, let me just take a listen to the scanner radio, couple police frequencies, make sure there's no activity. Still quiet. Check that other channel. Not much activity at all tonight. It's interesting. Okay. I think we're gonna have an easy night. Let's go over the tools of the trade, and then I'll go over the plan, and I have some masks for us, disguises, okay? So, the plan, let's go over the plan now, I guess. Get my whiteboard and my whiteboard marker, dry erase marker. Okay. See if I can do it like this. Okay. All right. So, put me and you. So that's me and you. Right. And now that's the bank. So the plan is we are going to go through the sewer entrance. That's the sewer entrance right there. And then we're gonna dig a tunnel. Okay, right here. I'm gonna dig a tunnel. And then I'll just use my fingers. And this is the bank vault. Here's all the money bags. We dig a tunnel into the vault, okay? We're gonna use a pickaxe to make a hole in the floor. Then we get all the money. Leave out through the sewer tunnel, a little that we dug straight up. And I have the car. We'll dig another tunnel. We'll dig another tunnel this way. Because they might expect us to escape the way we came in. And I'll have, then I'll have my car parked right here, okay? And then we'll just escape. So that's the plan. You want to take a look at it. Kind of, you want to memorize it. Put it to, what do they say? Put it to memory, something like that. Okay. So once again, it's me and you. It's me and you. And we're going to dig a tunnel under the bank. Go through the sewer entrance, take a tunnel up into the bank's, the vault floor, break open the vault. Actually, the more I think about it, we're not going to need the stethoscope because we'll be digging up. We're not going to need to break open the vault, you know, the main clicky thing, the lock, because we're digging right through the floor. They're not going to expect that. So again, sewer entrance, straight up into the vault, take the money, and dig another tunnel out to our escape vehicle. And that's the master plan, okay? It's a work of art. I know, thank you very much. You won't believe how long I spent to devise that plan. I came up with it myself. No one has ever done that in the history of robbing banks. So, yeah. When I'm telling you, once we go through with this, rob the, you know, get the money, escape, we're going to become infamous. We're going to become famously infamous. It's going to be great. So, okay, so that's the plan. You want to look at it, admire it one last time? Sure. Here you go. Okay, so, simple. Set that aside. And just in case you forget, because I know you're probably a little nervous and anxious, are you enjoying the tea? Starting to calm you down? Okay, great. If you happen to forget the plan, and you're like, oh man, what are we going to do again? What are we supposed to do? I'm going to take the dry erase board with us, so we won't forget, okay? So we'll have every step of the plan right there for easy reference, all right? So some of the tools that we'll need. You know what? I am going to bring the stethoscope because in the event that something happens when we're trying to dig up and maybe we dig outside of the vault, we may still need to break through the vault lock. So I'll bring everything just in case, okay? So this is the shovel. We can take turns digging, okay? Have you ever had to dig a tunnel before? No? Me neither. But how hard could it be? Just dig some dirt, you know, out of the ground. Should be fairly easy, especially since we're digging up. All the dirt should begin to fall straight down, yeah, you know, on top of us. That's okay. Get a little dirty. So this is the shovel. So that's the shovel we'll be using. Just put that back aside. And like I said, we can take turns shoveling. Now, you're probably wondering, Paul, Uncle E-E-R, whatever, dude, how are we gonna get through the cement of the sewer tunnel to dig through the dirt and the cement floor in the bank vault? Well, that's simple, my friend. With a pickaxe. we gotta do is just swing the pickaxe into the ceiling of the sewer. The ceiling, top of the sewer tunnel. Dig out the dirt and then use the pickaxe to pick away at the cement floor of the bank vault. And we make a hole right into the bank vault. Easy peasy. So, yeah, pickaxe. Have you ever had to use a pickaxe to break into a bank vault? No? Yeah, me neither. But like I said, I mean, there's nothing to it. We just swing the axe into the cement. It breaks open like an egg. So that's the pickaxe. We can take turns using the pickaxe too. Okay, my friend. All right, let's see. One last tool. Is a drill. It's electric, but I'm sure they'll have an outlet inside the bank vault, so no big deal, right? And you know, I'm sure that we're probably gonna need to drill to bypass some locks like you see in the movies, right? So. So I have this one drill bit. I have some others I can bring as well. So I think, I think this is gonna be perfect for some of the, what do they call them? Safety deposit boxes. We can just drill the locks out. And as long as there's an outlet, I'm sure there's an outlet. We might need an extension cord. I'll grab an extension cord before we start our mission. But so that's the drill. sure if I asked if you've ever used a drill to break into a safety deposit box before, to drill into a lock. No? Yeah, me neither. But again, I'm sure you've seen the movies. Easy peasy. So, okay. So that's the drill. Set that aside. Okay, oh yeah. Something just as equally important. A snack. I don't know about you, but I get kind of snacky. You know, just finished dinner not too long ago. Sure you have as well. It's gonna be another 20 minutes, half an hour before we're done here and we can go on our mission. So at some point, I'm gonna need a snack. So I got a little snack. So hopefully that will tide us over until we're done. Another tool is this hacksaw. Exactly what we'll need a hacksaw for, but we might need to hack a lock or bars, something metal, some kind. So this might come in very handy for something seen. There's another word I want to use, but something unpredictable that we might run into, that a hacksaw would be needed to hacksaw. Okay. Have you ever used a hacksaw to rob a bank? No? Yeah, me neither. I think I've seen a hacksaw used in a couple movies, but in any case, this should come in handy. Set that aside. Okay. Next, some leather gloves, obviously, to hide our fingerprints. I was thinking about burning our fingertips, slicing off our fingertips, but, you know, I'm not really into pain. I don't know about you, but, I just prefer not to do that, so. So we'll just use leather gloves to hide our fingerprints. So that's the leather gloves. You can have these. You can borrow these, okay? I'll need them back. Okay, so next, self-defense. I'm not a violent person. But when it comes down to it, when my hand is forced and I have to defend myself, I'll be violent in a self-defense situation. So in the event that local or federal law enforcement officials find out what we're doing and go to commence to apprehend us, to bring us into custody, I don't know about you, but I don't want to go to prison. And I also don't want to shoot anyone lethally. So I have a few Nerf guns that we can use for self-defense, okay? They're loaded. This one is a chain, is like a mini chainsaw Nerf gun. It has fires, two bullets. See right here? One, two. And then it has this saw accessory, saw blade. So you can use this as a ranged weapon, or if the local or federal law enforcement officials are very close to seizing you in their custody, you can switch quickly from ranged combat to melee combat, and you can use the saw blade on them, okay? So we have that's one self-defense choice. We have another smaller. It's like a 22, maybe a Colt 45, something in there, between that range. Fires two bullets. One. Take a listen to the quality of these bullets. Now, I know you're probably, I can see a little bit of a smirk on your face. You're probably thinking, how are Nerf guns gonna protect us, defend ourselves from the cops or the feds? Let me tell you, have you ever been shot, hit by a Nerf gun? Especially in the eye, in the facial region area, ear, they sting pretty bad. So this, they're not lethal. They won't stun the law enforcement officials, but they'll sting enough to provide a momentary distraction, just enough time for us to make our getaway. got your second Nerf gun self-defense option. I have one more. And this is the hammer shot. One, two, three, four. Shoots five Nerf bullets, okay? Just imagine the cop or the fed about to apprehend you for just robbing a bank. You pull this bad boy out. Bang, 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 bang. Shoot him five times. He gets pelted in the face. It stings. He's blinded, can't see, and you're off running, getting away. I mean, it's awesome. One, two. There's the bullet holder thingy. So that's your third choice. So which one would you like? We can only take one of each. The five shot. The two shot with the saw blade. Or the smaller, more up close and personal two-shot pistol-like. Which one? You're not sure? Okay, that's fine. I'll put them on the table. You can take whichever one when we're about to leave. Okay, all right. Three more things to go. The next one is the first aid kit, just in case something happens while we're shoveling using the pickaxe. Maybe I swing the pickaxe and part of it, you know, I smack into your skull, go right through your skull into your brain. No. Or you're swinging the pickaxe and it goes right through my rib cage, punctures the lung. Maybe you're using the drill, trying to drill through a lock, slips, you drill into your kneecap. Maybe we get shot by the police, bullets, just we get riddled with bullets. So what do? You need some first aid. That's where the first aid kit comes in, okay? This has everything we could need. Let me show you. Has that great first aid kit smell. Bandages. Yeah. So there are some things missing. I've had to use this some of my role play videos. But over here on the left, you can see some band-aids, some gauze. Over here on the right, it's a blue strap thing. I don't know what that's for. Maybe a tourniquet. And a a blanket. It's like a tin foil blanket. It's a like a heat blanket when you're when you're cold or anything. You wrap it around you. I can kind of show you how it works. It's a first aid blanket. It's a mouth-to-mouth thing. Take a look at that. Yeah, some bandages, typical stuff. You know, I bought this for some role play videos. So what you do with this so that you don't put your mouth directly on someone else's mouth. This just goes, I guess, I think this part goes, one part goes over the mouth. Maybe this goes into their mouth. And then or maybe this way. I don't think that way. It's too flat. I think it's this way. Something like that. This is going to be quite noisy. The first aid blanket, show you how that works. see. Keeps your body heat in, like if you're being wrapped in tin foil, pretty much. You could use this to keep yourself warm when you're bleeding out, but you could use this during any cold situation or scenario, I guess. I can feel myself getting warmer already. It's kind of nice. It's okay. I'll just put it into the next thing we'll need that we'll have to use to carry all the money out. Is the duffel bag. So that's the duffel bag, and we'll put all the money in there, some of our tools, and we can take turns carrying it, because I'm sure there's going to be gold bars, stacks of Benjamins, just a ton of money that we'll be escaping with. So the duffel bag, perfect. Alright, my friend, well, this is it. One last thing to show you, and then you and I are off to rob our very first bank. Next. Probably thinking, all this stuff is great, Paul, ER, whatever, But how are we gonna hide our identities from the security cameras or from any of the federal or local law enforcement that show up trying to ID us? That, my friend, is why I bought pantyhose. Have you ever worn pantyhose before as a mask? No, me neither. Did you know they have so many different kinds of pantyhose that you can buy? I never really quite understood these either. My wife doesn't wear pantyhose. I think my mom may have worn them. I have this vague recollection of seeing pantyhose somewhere. And maybe it's just the only reason I may have seen my mom's pantyhose when I was a kid, just going into my parents' bedroom. But if it's not my mom, maybe I've seen them. I've seen so many movies over the 52 years I've been alive. Well, 52 years as of right now, that maybe I've just seen a movie with pantyhose laying around somewhere and I think I saw them in real life. I don't know. They make a lot of different pantyhose, though. I don't know the purpose. Is it just to make women use them just to make their legs look more cleaner, to hide blemishes? Is that what it's all about, just to look, you know, a certain way? I don't get them. So pantyhose for masks. Let me open this up. Let's see. Little noisy. There's one for you. Set it right here on the table. One for me. And I think all you have to do is like this. I'm not sure what to do with these parts. Maybe this way. Just cut these parts off, or maybe have them hang down like that. All right, so I can kind of see, out of them a little bit. It's almost like wearing a morph suit when I did the Green Man video. So, anyway, make a nice sound, I think. Can breathe out of it easily enough. So, could cut these off, I guess. These are the legs. Could probably cut these off or just, yeah. But now, the reason that we should wear pantyhose instead of a ski mask, because this blurs the face, especially the eyes, facial features. so that security cameras might catch us, right? I didn't get spray paint. I should have got spray paint to spray paint the security cameras. But they won't be able to recognize our features. So this is perfect, okay? So you have your pantyhose, I have mine. And my friend, that's it. We are ready to go rob a bank. What do you say? All right, great. I'll pack everything into the duffel bag and we'll go right into my car. We could call an Uber, but they might think something suspicious of us wearing pantyhose. So we'll take my car, okay? And by this time tomorrow night, you and I are gonna be rich beyond our wildest dreams. What are you gonna do with all that money? And we'll split it 50-50, okay? What are you gonna do with all that money? Yeah. Me? I don't know. I'm just, I don't know what I'm gonna do with all that money that we steal from the bank. Let's see, I might buy a bag of new socks, maybe another colorful shirt. Let's see, I do need a new chef's knife. The chef's knife that we have is kind of dull. Need to buy one of those. I really don't know. Maybe a Segway, so I could just scoot around, go grocery shopping on my Segway. Yeah, I don't really know. Haven't got that far yet. One step at a time. Let's rob the bank first, then we can come back and celebrate, okay? All right, my friend, so you ready to rob a bank? All right, excellent. Let's get to it. Let's load everything up into the duffel bag. Snacks. First aid kit. I'll bring all the guns. Stethoscope. To mention, I have this toy lantern. This will be perfect when we need to look in the sewer as we're digging the tunnels, okay? Lantern. Leather gloves. Oh, that's your pair. Extra pair of bullets. And let's give the scanner radio one more listen before we go, okay? You ready? Because this is it. Okay, a little anxious. No, you're completely calm. Perfect. So am I. Still quiet. No police chatter. Okay, great. Take that with us too. All right, my friend, let's go rob a bank.